NBC2 first exposed Legendary Journeys in 2017. The travel agency abruptly closed, leaving customers without trips or refunds.
Now you won't believe what the owners are accused of doing with the money. NBC2 investigator Evan Dean found out.
It was the fall of 2017 when it all went south for Legendary Journeys. Customers of this Sarasota-based travel agency had booked trips, paid good money, but suddenly...
our cruise had been canceled due to non-payment.
So that came kind of as a shock.
That's when the little red flags went up.
Jerry and Carolyn Ross said their trip was going to be special. The pair and some friends booked a cruise for their 50th wedding anniversary.
We had all paid, but Legendary Journeys had not paid.
In an email to customers, Legendary Journeys blamed the cancellations on employee theft, hurricanes, even terrorism, and abruptly shut down.
That included airfare, that included touring.
The company's president, Al Ferguson, promised full refunds to customers.
It's been 2 years, and you have how much of it back?
None.
Not a cent?
No.
2 years later.
Right.
Yeah.
Where is it?
Where is it? Where'd the money go? These customers are now finally getting some answers after the NBC2 investigators obtained a civil lawsuit filed by the Attorney General against Legendary Journeys.
When you found out how big this was.
Wow.
I couldn't believe it.
No.
In the lawsuit, the AG's office says more than 800 customers have made claims against the travel agency, totaling more than $3 million in losses.
Just mind-boggling to me.
It infuriates me. I'll be honest with you.
The lawsuit says Ferguson and his spouse, company vice president Charles Scott, misappropriated company money, effectively stealing from people who'd paid for travel. Among the allegations, the AG says Ferguson spent $143,000 in company money to pay off his credit card balances and used Legendary Journeys funds to pay for monthly massage and gym fees and charges at bars and restaurants. The complaint also says Scott spent a staggering $44,000 at Saks Fifth Avenue using company credit and another $14,000 at a jewelry designer.
How does that make you feel?
Uh-huh. Got ripped off. He stole our money and he's spending it, having a good time.
It's nice when you can spend someone else's money.
Yes, I'd like to buy something from Saks.
Legendary Journeys never issued refunds, instead filing for an assignment for the benefit of creditors, an alternative to a bankruptcy filing. An appointee on the case has spent the past 2 years rounding up and selling off company assets to try to get customers their money back. They're still waiting.
You haven't gotten anything.
Nothing. Nothing.
No.
Nothing whatsoever.
Not sure that we ever will.
But you could understand where the frustration is, you know.
Sure.
Independent bankruptcy attorney Richard Johnston says it could actually be a good sign that it's taking longer.
That could mean that the creditors are going to get more back.
Could be, but it still may not be enough.
Not enough, because the AG says company assets will likely be dwarfed by the consumer's massive claims.
I give up my money that he owes us to see him go to jail.
So what is Al Ferguson up to these days anyway?
Only on Happening.
He's part of South Florida entertainment shows that regularly broadcast on Facebook Live.
Good evening, South Florida.
His former customers wish he was somewhere else.
I personally feel if I did it, I would be in jail. I don't see any reason why I wouldn't be.
So the AG is seeking restitution and fines, but confirmed they have not filed criminal charges. Al Ferguson has lawyered up and he's fighting the lawsuit, denying most of the allegations in it. I tried reaching him, called, texted, went through social media, but have not yet heard back. For the NBC2 investigators, I'm Evan Dean.